was just lovely because the film was made with so much kind of love and well, like any film is, you know, when you put so much effort and you don't know how it's going to be, how people are going to respond, and the response has just been wonderful. So it's been great.
The first time to sit and watch it in front of an audience as well, or with an audience, to watch this kind of movie and get all the reactions and the big moments was incredible with the volunteer screening we went to the other day. Well, it's set in 1630 in New England. It's a scary folk tale of a family that had left England and set up in have been kicked out of that Puritan plantation that they live on. The father, William, that I play, has fallen out with the elders in the Puritan plantation. We've been banished, shed to from the plantation, and we set up in the wilderness, and things don't go very well.
To be honest, I really think it's a family thing. It's because we were all spending so much time together, you instantly bond and you forge those relationships, and you know, Thomason isn't anything without, you know, the people that she grew up with, and you know, that's who she is. So it was really just these guys and, you know, in-depth discussions with Rob. Yeah, that was pretty much it.
I was in London and I found someone selling matches on the street, and
it was me.
I mean, we had a great UK casting director, Carmel Cochran, and Anya was, you know, when she auditioned, it was clear that she was the only person who could play the role. I mean, it's insane that this is her first real role. Because what was so striking to me is that she has the ability to be so natural, but the way she was able to work with this complicated language is like someone who has classical training. Like it's so specific, like her work with the dialogue and you know, like working with all these guys, you know, when they're delivering these lines, it's like how I imagined it, you know, when I wrote it. It's very satisfying. I grew up in New England, and I'm sure this sounds kind of precious, but it's true that New England's past was always part of my consciousness. And, you know, like there's all these crumbling colonial farmhouses and hidden graveyards in the woods and stuff. And so that world and very much witches was part of my like childhood imaginary playground. And so and I wanted to capture that in a film and make an archetypal New England horror story. Something that felt like a nightmare from the past, like a Puritan family's nightmare, something that felt like, did I just say an inherited nightmare? You know, like when you have the weight of an intensity of the past, the way we like came together to make this so visceral, like I think it has a kind of power, like this, like a, you know, I don't know. Does that make any sense?
Yes.
Strangely excited to do something so bizarre. It's perfect for the movie. So I like things that really push and frighten me and are kind of weird. And it's just, it was a strange scene to film.
I arrived on the set just as they finished. I was coming to film the next scene, and everything was very quiet walking up to this house. And then suddenly they'd obviously yelled cut, and 30 people came running out of this house screaming. They all go,
oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God.
And I had no idea what they were filming. It was that scene that they'd been filming.
Probably the most intense, weirdest, terrifying thing I've done in a great way. It's kind of difficult to articulate. I was slightly hysterical after
slightly.
It. Yeah.
But it was great, and it was great that we managed to do it. I know it's a really horrible thing to look at.
The cast was like incredible, and how their commitment to the piece, that I think also like and the key crew members in every single department like kept us going and happy and passionate, because the weather was horrible always, always trying to deal with the weather, and it was an extremely remote location with no cell service and no Wi-Fi, and we were traveling like, you know, 45, 50 minutes to get there every day, I mean, the animals were very, 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 very difficult to work with.
Charlie the goat.
The kids were, you know, fantastic to work with, but whenever you have kids, their short hours make things, you know, complicated. Mm-hmm. And shoot, like, laying, you know, 60 to 80 dolly track in the woods. Like, I mean, there's not a simple, I can't think of a simple shot in the movie, you mm-hmm. know, it was really challenging, but extremely satisfying to have those kinds of obstacles and to conquer them, even though you sort of wake up like half in tears the next morning. You know?